I'm back with a sermon, and I was looking at doubt, the last sermon that I was doing, and I was looking at Deuteronomy 4:2, and as it says, do not add what I command you, and do not subtract from it, but keep the commands to the Lord your God that I give you. This is a pure example that Jesus commands us to love one another. Jesus commands us to do this with love, with compassion, with kindness, and to follow the word of God and do what the word of God says. But unfortunately, the people of this world and the people that are not of God and obviously are dead because they do not give their life to Jesus and they are of this world. It says, do not subtract. Do not wander away from the word of God. Don't wander away from the word of God and then come back and then subtract from it and etc. But do what God commands you to do. And as God says from it, but keep the commands of the Lord your God. Keep the commands of your Lord, of your God. Keep the keep the commands of the Lord your God that I give you. We all can see from this scripture of Deuteronomy 4:2 and then into 3. You saw with your own eyes. We've all seen with our own eyes of living in this world what destruction and what evil that there is out there and what it does. And we all know that is not the answer. We know the answer is love, kindness, compassionate. Not doing evil, but doing good. Doing good and following the word of God and doing what God commands us and following Jesus Christ. At the end of the day, we all want to do good. We all want to be compassionate. We all want to be kind as God commands us to do. But in this scripture, in Deuteronomy 4, and this is just looking at it in another way, you saw with your own eyes what the Lord did to Baal Peor. The Lord your God destroyed from among everyone who followed this Baal Peor. But all of you who held fast to the Lord your God are still alive today. See, at the end of the day, if we hold steadfast to God and we believe in what God has commanded us to do and we held fast to the Lord your God, you will stay alive because you're alive in God. But as soon as you go back into the world, you are dead. But when you give your life to Jesus Christ, you are alive in Jesus Christ. You start your new life from that day forward. You are born again. You start your new life in God and you are full of light. And suddenly the world disappears because darkness cannot be where there is light. When there is light and darkness, darkness disappears. Darkness disappears wherever there is light. You turn on a light in a house where there is a dark room. As soon as you turn the light on, the dark disappears. We all know that. So the simple fact is, if we look at Deuteronomy 4:2, do not add to what I command you, and do not subtract. If you are subtracting from the word of God and you're doing these things and you are doubting what God commands us to do and what God is putting on your heart, what the Holy Spirit is burning on your heart. And these are the things that we need to be looking at. If we go to John's 15, so we all turn our Bibles to John's 15. These are the things that we've got to know. These things, if we're doubting, if we're being selfishness, if we're not being kind, compassionate and loving, then we need to question our hearts. We need to say, why are we being selfish? Why are we doubting? Why are we lacking humility? These are things that are not of God. The things of God is not doubting, is having humility, being kind, compassionate and loving. These things are of God. Being disciplined in God, these things are of God. But if we go to... we can go to John 10 first. And in John 10 verses 11, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for his sheep. They hide a hand in the shepherd who owns the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because he is hired hand and cares nothing for his sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know my sheep, and my sheep knows me, just as my Father knows me, and I know the Father. I lay down my life for my sheep. See, Jesus laid his life down God allowed his only son to be sacrificed on the cross, to shed his blood on the cross, that your sins will be saved. So, and I lay down my life for my sheep. I have other sheep that are not of this sheep pen. I must bring them also. They too will listen to my voice, and they shall be of one flock and one shepherd. Reason my Father loves me is that I lay down my life, only to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down for my own accord. I have the authority to lay it down and authority to take it up again. This command I received from my Father. He received this command from his Father, and he didn't subtract from it. He didn't do anything else but listened and did the commandment of his Father. So if we go to John's 15, I am the true vine. So in John's 15, it says, I am the true vine. The true vine is Jesus. And my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, so that he will have more fruit for him. You are already clean because of the word I have spoken to you. Remain in me, and I will remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. So it must remain in Jesus. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine and you are the branches. If a man remains in me and I in him, he will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. If anyone does not remain in me, he is like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up and thrown into the fire and burned. If you remain in me and my word remains in you, ask whatever you wish and it will be given to you. This is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourself to be my disciples. As the Father has loved me, so I love you. Now remain in my love. He commands us to remain in his love. This is John's 15. I'm going to leave it there on doubt, and I'm going to go on to the next one, which is having contentment in God. And I'm going to finish it up very soon, and then we can pray.